This is Mr. Social, and this is Miss Business. They both live in a world full of gaps and contradictions. A world where around 1.73 billion people, one-fifth of the population, live in absolute poverty, meaning on less than $1 a day. In this world, the upper 20% of the population possess 83% of the wealth. More and more people end up in poverty, and the gap between the poor and the industrialized countries keeps ever widening. But the financial crisis of 2008 has made it strikingly obvious that not only the global south is suffering from inequalities. In the northern countries, poverty rates have been increasing rapidly, despite a surge in gross national product. In order to combat injustices between countries and individuals, Mr. Social has been working hard. He founded a whole bunch of social institutions, charity groups, and development organizations funded by individuals, governments, and foundations. In the meantime, Miss Business set up a foundation too. Since she found out that her clients are more willing to buy her products if they consider her to be active for a good cause. But in spite of employing people like Mr. Social, she maintained her general orientation towards profit maximization. Thus far, Mr. Social and Miss Business have always gone separate ways, even though they depend on each other. Mr. Social on the direct and indirect financial support of Miss Business, and Miss Business on the good reputation and the involvement of Mr. Social within society. But they have never grown any closer and never showed any real interest in each other's activities. Until one day, when a man named Muhammad Yunus appeared with a new idea, a business model bringing both the social and the business sectors together. He called it social business. A social business addresses social needs in a financially sustainable way. And while investors may recoup their investment, all further profits are reinvested to advance the social goal. When Miss Business and Mr. Social found out about this new business model, they suddenly became aware of a dissatisfaction they had been feeling about their own work. Ever since Miss Business became successful, she had been missing some deeper sense of satisfaction and admired Mr. Social's selflessness. Meanwhile, Mr. Social had been marveling at the efficiency and independency of Miss Business. Looking at each other for the first time, they suddenly realized that they were a perfect match. So finally, they fell in love with each other and soon set up a new joint business, a social business. Mr. and Mrs. Social Business hope that one day, social businesses will account for 5% of the world's economy. They recommend everyone to spend time getting involved in social businesses, step by step, fulfilling the dream of freeing the world of social problems.